I'm Selma Teacher 7, also known as Mr. Barry by my students, and today is lesson number 4 for the computer literacy and also known as the computer proficiency class. Now for today, we're going to be getting into our Google accounts, going into our Google Drive, and then to our particular projects folder. Now once you're into the projects folder, we're going to be going to create a new Google document. And today, we're making a Valentine's card. So, let's get started with the lesson. Lesson number 4, using Google Docs to create a greeting card. Practice with Google Docs. Number 1, let's start the Chrome browser by clicking on its icon or opening up your Chromebooks. Number 2, if the browser is not showing the Google web page, then you can go to the Google website by keying in Google into the address box and then hitting the shortcut Control Enter. This will put the www.com for the Google into the address box and load the Google page for us. So let's go over to google.com here. You may be there already. Number 3. The Google website should load, showing you the user who is logged in, and hopefully you have your avatar showing that you are logged in. If you're not logged in to at this time, then please log in now. You do this by clicking on the blue sign in button found in the upper right hand corner and then typing in the correct username and password in the spaces provided, as seen here. Now, after logging in, be so kind as to click on the apps icon. And it should look like a set of 9 small gray squares. Number 6, a menu should appear. Please note, the flying saucers are here to point out special notes, so pay attention whenever you see one. Number 7, click on the Google Drive icon. Now for some of my students, they have made a shortcut or a favorites on their bookmarks for the Google Drive. They went to it and then they clicked on the little star, and so they actually see it in their bookmark bars. If you see it, you can do that and just click on the Google Drive icon. Number 8. The Google Drive should load as seen here. Notice in the top left hand corner it says Google Drive, and then on the right hand side you'd have your avatar as it shows in mine. Number 9. Double click on your projects folder to open it. So look for your folder that says Project Folder 2017. And double click that for me. Number 10, the project folder should open and load as seen here. Now you know you're in your folder once at the top here it'll say My Drive caret project folder. Number 11, click on the large new button found on the upper left-hand corner. Once you click on the new button, a menu will appear below it. Be so kind as to click Google Docs, as seen here. Let's now go on to page 3. A dialog box should open asking you if you want to create in a shared folder. Click the OK button now. A new page should load, showing a blank document within Google Docs. For a few of my students, they've also seen another message that comes up. It says, if you are asked to create this document in templates, click No Thanks. 14. Click on the document's title where it says Untitled Document on the top left-hand corner and give it a name, Project 2, as seen here. After typing in the words Project 2 in that space provided in the top left-hand corner, hit the Enter key once. Did you know there's another way to rename a document? All you have to do is click on File and then go down and click on Rename and then simply type in the new name. So those are two very easy ways of renaming your document. One is by clicking on Untitled Document and typing in the new name, or by going to File and then clicking on Rename and typing it there. Let's now go on to page 4. Click on File. The File menu should appear as seen here. 16. Click on Page Setup, found at the bottom of this menu. 17. The Page Setup window should appear. Notice on the Page Setup, you'll have the words Page Setup, Orientation, and these other settings that we can now change. 18. Change the orientation from portrait to landscape, and that's done by taking your mouse and clicking on landscape right here. The next thing you want to do is go and change your margins to being 0.5, as seen in the above image right here that I'm circling. So you would go to the top margin, click in there, and you can use your backspace to delete the old numbers that were in there and say 0.5. To jump down to the next cell, use the tab key. So just go tab and then hit 0.5 again to put the numbers in the bottom margin. Hit tab again, and then the left margin becomes highlighted. Hit 0.5 again, and then tab one more time and type in 0.5. What's going to happen is, after doing all this, it should look just like what it shows on the screen, where we have the word landscape, has the dot on it, the top margin all the way through the left have 0.5 all the way through. Okay, now let's now jump to page 5. Click on the OK button after changing the margins and the orientation. Step 20. After clicking on the blue OK button, you should notice that the document has changed its size in respect to the ruler found near the top of your document. 21. Take your mouse and click on the word Table, found in the toolbar. The table menu should appear as seen here. Step 22. Click on Insert Table, or just float on that. And when you do, notice that this menu appears. Click on the second cell to create a table that has two columns in one row. So click on that second cell, and when you click on the second cell, that window and menu go away. Step 23. A table should appear within your document as seen here. 24. Center the text by clicking on the center aligned icon found on your toolbars near the top of your screen. You can also use the shortcut Control Shift E to center the text. So if for some reason it's hard for you to find the center align icon, you can always use the shortcut Control Shift E. 25. Hit the Enter key 34 times to increase the size of this table. Now, if you make a mistake, just click the Undo button. So go ahead and hit that 34 times. Okay, hopefully you've hit it 34 times. Now we're ready for step 26. The insertion point should be at the bottom of the table as seen here. Type created by and then insert your name as seen here. So notice on mine I typed in created by Daniel Berry. On yours it'd be created by and then your name goes there. So just type in your name. Page number 6. Step 27. Hit the Tab key once to move the insertion point to the next cell of the table. The Tab key is found on the left-hand side of the keyboard and looks like this. Step 28. The insertion point should be on the top of the second cell now, as seen here. Center the text by clicking on the center aligned icon. And now center the text on the second cell. Okay, now go ahead and sit back and I'm going to do a quick introduction of word art. You don't have to do these steps. I'm going to show you how to do this here. Google's WordArt is a wonderful tool which can be found in the larger drawing tool. It contains a collection of decorative text graphics which may be inserted into any document. Once the image has been inserted into the document, it may be resized, rotated to any angle. And notice, this is an example of word art. Notice you can also change the colors, the handwriting of the word art. Also, you can add things such as a shadow or rotate it any way that you want to. Step 29. Now back to our document. To find this useful and wonderful tool, take your mouse and click on Insert, found near the top toolbar there. Click on Insert. Now, once you've clicked on Insert, the Insert menu should appear as seen here. Step 31. Click on the Drawing link found within the Insert menu. Page 7. Step 32. The drawing tool should open as seen here. Notice it will say drawing actions. It will have an undo, redo, magnifying or zoom, and other tools. Step 33. Locate the actions button and click it to reveal its menu. Click on the link called WordArt, which is found within the Actions menu. So here we see it, Actions, and then I clicked on WordArt. 35. A small text box should appear and open as seen here. Notice it says use the Enter to save. So when you are done typing, hit the Enter key once, and that saves your work. If you want to go down to the next line, use Shift Enter. Page 8. Step 36. Key in the word happy, as seen here, without the quotation marks. Remember, do not use the arrow key to jump to the next line. Step 37. After keying in the word happy, use the shortcut Shift Enter to lower the insertion point one space, as seen here. Key in the word Valentine's Day without the quotation marks on the second line. After keying in Happy Valentine's Day into the dialog box, hit the Enter key once. The drawing window will change, as seen here. So notice now it says Happy Valentine's Day, and there's a blue square around it. Page 9, step number 40. Change the font of the word art by clicking on the word Arial font found near the top. And just to let you know, if you're using a small screen, such as an 11-inch screened Chromebook, then you can click on More, and then Arial is revealed in there. So click on Arial, and then go down and click on Lobster. Now we added the lobster font in the last lesson. If you did not see lobster when we do step number 40, you can add lobster by going down to More Fonts and then finding lobster in the list by typing in the word lobster, clicking on the word lobster, and then clicking on Add, and done. And that's how you add new fonts now. Step 41. The text Happy Valentine's Day should change, as seen here. Click on the Fill Color tool found within the drawing menu. It's an icon that looks like a can of paint being spilled out. When you float your mouse over, it does say its name, Fill Color. 43. Once the Fill Color tool is clicked, a color palette should appear as seen here, showing you many different colors. 10. Step 44, select the red color from within the color palette. So click on red there. Step 45, the color of the text should change to red, as seen here. And it'll look just like this. 46. Now take your mouse and click on the Save and Close button found near the top of your screen there. 47. The document should look like this on your screen. Notice you have a table with the two cells, and on the right hand cell it says Happy Valentine's Day. Let's go on now to page 11. Step 48. Hit the Enter key twice to lower the insertion point. The Enter key looks like this, and it says Enter on it. Quick introduction to images. Images is a collection of pictures and graphics which may be inserted into any document. Once the image has been inserted into the document, it may be resized or even cropped. These tools look useful, so let's look at all the tools whenever we click on an image. If I click on an image only once, I have the rotating tool, which is found towards the top, and it is round, like a round ball, and it's colored blue. I also have resizing tools, and these can be used simply by taking your mouse and then dragging to the center, and that will make it smaller, and dragging away from the center will cause the image to appear larger. The text wrapping style, so we have inline, wrap text, or break text. Remember, any image may be cropped by double clicking the image and then dragging the black lines as seen here. So if you look at the image here, if I had double clicked it and then I dragged this black line up and over, you notice how all the area in gray would be cut off of the image, and we call that cropping. The image tools always appear whenever an image is clicked upon. And they look like this, where you have image options. Within the image options box, there are many ways to customize the image, such as changing its transparency, brightness, or even its contrast. Let's now go on to the next page here. Let's insert an image into our greeting card. Step number 50. To insert an image into this document, click on the word Insert found on the top toolbar. 51. Once you click on Insert, a menu will pop down. 52. Click on the word Image, which should be the very first word, or the top word, in this menu. 53. The Insert Image window should open as seen here. If you look at the items on this box here, it says upload. This allows you to upload an image or a picture that you might have on your computer. You can take a snapshot with your computer's camera. You can look for the image by its address or URL address. You can look through your albums, like your Google Photo albums. You can look through your Google Drive for your images. Or you can click on search. In this case, I'd like you to click on the search option, which is the very last word on the list. Let's now go on to page 13. Step 55. The window should change in appearance to the one shown here, with the word search underlined and it says Google. 56. Type in the words Valentine's Day into the search box and hit the enter key once. 57. The window should change to the one shown here. 58. Click on the image of the heart that is made of candy. It will look like this. 59. After clicking on the image of the heart made of candy, take your mouse and click on the blue select button to insert the image into your document. It's going on to step number 60. Your document should now look like this. step 61. Click once in the center of the image of the heart. 62. Blue squares should surround the image. These squares allow you to resize the image. The circle towards the stop center allows you to rotate the image. And the text box at the bottom of the image allows you to change the image's wrapping style. Double-clicking the image reveals black lines, which allows you to crop the image. 63. Take your mouse and go to the blue square that's found in the lower right-hand corner there. Okay. Once you're right on that square, your mouse pointer should change its appearance to two arrows. Drag the lower right blue square towards the center of the image. Then release the mouse clicker. When you have resized the image to half its original size, as seen here, any corner square will do the same. Remember, a drag is performed by holding down the left mouse clicker on the element and then moving the element to its desired position, and letting go of the clicker once the desired position is achieved. So the image will be resized and become a little bit smaller, as seen here. Step 64. Take your mouse and click once below the table to unhighlight the image of the heart. So click down here, below the table in the white space provided down here. Once you've clicked below the table, you're ready for step 65. 65, hit the enter key 7 times to move the insertion point down to the second page. This is the inside cover of your Valentine's card. '66. Center the text by clicking on the center aligned icon. '67. Type this message. You are invited, comma, and then hit the enter key once. To come and share, and then hit the enter key once. In warm fellowship, and then hit the enter key once. And warmer food. And then hit the enter key once. This Valentine's Day at our humble home. Okay, now after keying in this text, this is what you should see in the center of the second page of your project. Now while you're hopefully finishing up that text, we're going to go on to talk about fonts. Fonts in detail. What is a font? Well, a font is a particular size, weight, and style of a typeface. You might call it a handwriting style. Notice how the font called Lobster has a particular style so that all the letters match together, as we see here. Fonts can be changed by clicking on the font name found on their toolbar. Normally we either have Calibri or Arial as the one listed at the top. Google Docs has hundreds of different fonts. To find more fonts, just click on More Fonts found at the bottom of this font list. Any font can be added simply by selecting that font and then clicking on the blue OK button. So notice that we have literally thousands and thousands of different types of fonts. And instead of having to scroll down through the entire list, if you know its name, you click in the box, begin typing its name, and as you're typing its name, it'll come up and be shown here. Let's go on to the next page. Fonts can also be changed in size by clicking on the number found on the toolbar and then selecting the new number size. Here we have 11 is the default size, but if I went 8, the font would appear smaller. And if I chose a larger number, such as 14 or 18 or even larger, it will appear larger on the page. Now, back to the greeting card. Hopefully by now, everyone has typed in that message. 68. Highlight the message. Now remember, highlighting is done by taking your mouse and dragging over that message so it all becomes highlighted. That can be done by clicking at the top left and then holding down the mouse clicker and dragging all the way to the bottom right of the message and everything will become highlighted. If you do make a mistake, hit the undo key or use the shortcut Control Z to undo the mistake. So what we want to do is highlight the message and then change its font size to 48. Now we change the font size by clicking on the number 11 down near the top of your screen in the toolbars. When you click on 11, all these numbers will appear. Click once on 48. 69. With the message still highlighted, change the font to Impact by clicking on the font style and then clicking on once on Impact, and it will change all that text for us. Let's go on now to step 70. Click once below the message to unhighlight it. So click down here below your message and your message now will become unhighlighted. That means it'll look just like what we have here on this page. And it should say, you are invited to come and share in warm fellowship and warmer food this Valentine's Day at our humble home. Step 71, change the font size to 11 by clicking on the font size. It should be 48 and then going and then clicking once on 11. 72. Once you have changed the font size, key in the address 123 Northwest Easter Avenue without the quotation marks, and it should appear like this, where you'll have your message and it'll appear very large, but then your address appears very small at the bottom. After keying in the address, 123 Northwest Easter Avenue, we're ready for step number 73. Take your mouse and highlight the address by dragging your mouse over the text. The text should become highlighted in a light blue color as seen here. Step 74. Copy the text by using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-C. Remember, a shortcut is done by holding down the first key on the list and then tapping the second key once and then letting go of both keys. So in this case, we press and hold the Control key, and then we take our other finger and we tap the C key once and we let go of both keys. Step 75. Scroll up to the first page of the letter and click in the area immediately to the right of the image of the heart as seen in this picture. So what I'd like you to do is scroll up to the first page and then click, take your mouse and click once in this area, which is adjacent to the image as I'm showing here, and with the arrow and circle. You can click anywhere in this area. Step number 76. Once you have clicked in that area, hit the enter key once. The insertion point should now be directly below the image of the heart as seen here in this image. So you'll have your heart, and then right below it, you'll have the insertion point flashing right there. 77. Paste the text of the address by using the shortcut Control V. Remember, just hold down the Control key and then tap the V once and it will paste the address as seen here. 78. The address should appear below the image of the heart. Guess what? Your card is complete! Yay! 79. This document is being shared automatically with Mr. Barry because it was created within your shared folder. In this lesson, we've covered a number of great features found within Google Docs. Number one, we discovered how to rename a Google Doc. We went into changing the page margins and the page orientation. We also went into using the ruler to gauge the position of the text within a Google Doc. We learned how to insert tables. We learned how to center the text. We learned how to use the undo button. We went into using the tab key to jump to the next cell within a table. We also learned how to use the WordArt tool found within the insert menu. We also learned how to copy and paste by using the shortcut Control C and Control V. We also learned how to insert an image and how to resize, rotate, or even crop an image. We learned how to change the font and how to change the size of the font. Now, let's go to the next page. Review questions for lesson number 4. Take a clean sheet of paper and write your name along the top line after answering the questions found on the next page. Turn in the paper into Mr. Barry. Now, for those who are not taking it for credit, as those students who are doing it for enrichment, you do not need to turn in the questions. In fact, you may write in the book that you have. Question number 1. Under which menu can you find page setup? Question number two. What is the shortcut that we use to insert the www and the .com into web addresses? Now remember, we do this shortcut when we're on an internet browser, such as your Chrome browser, and you also work within the Microsoft's internet browsers as well. Question number three. What is this called? Question number four. What is this called? Question number five. This book's orientation is portrait or is it landscape? Question number six. What does this icon do? Question number seven. What is the name of this icon? Question number eight. What is the name of the tool that allows us to create nice logos and fancy text? Number nine. Which menu holds the images link? Number 10. What is the name of this icon? Number 11. Images can be rotated to any angle. Is this true, false, or none of the above? Number 12. Google Drive is free. Is this true, false, or none of the above? Number 13. The redo option is in the... Is it in the view menu? The edit menu? Tools menu, or none of the above? Number 14. The print option is in the file menu, edit menu, tools menu, or none of the above? Step number 15. Documents can be created with, is it Hangouts, Google Docs, Google Pro, or none of the above? Step number 16. Text and images can be pasted into a document. Is this true, false, or none of the above? Number 17. The ruler is found where? At the bottom? At the top? On the left side? Or is it all the above? Number 18. Which image tool is used to rotate an image within Google Docs? Is it the small square, the circle, the triangle, or none of the above? Let's now go on to 19. Which image tool is used to resize an image within Google Docs? Is it the small blue square, the circle, the triangle, or none of the above? Number 20. Which image tool is used to crop an image within Google Docs? Is it this one? This one? This one? Or is it all of them? Alrighty, well, we've done a great deal in today's lesson. And for those who are doing this for credit, just make sure you do turn in those. For those who are watching on YouTube, make sure you do click on the thumbs up to like the video, share the video, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Thank you so very kindly for taking the time to watch the video. I hope everyone has a very good day. Bye-bye.